Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to show you about the California polish. It's made for aluminum, chrome. It's a two-part solution. It's got a deoxidizer in one bottle, and the other bottle is a polish. I'm going to show you how it works using a Freightliner Cascadia that has no chrome on it. Only cast aluminum, catwalk, steps, everything's aluminum. I'll show you how we can polish it. Alright, so this is everything you're going to need. California Custom Original Purple Metal Polish. California Custom Aluminum Deoxidizer. Set of towels. And it's best to have a polishing cloth. Both of which you can get at any truck stop. These here primarily sell at chrome shops. Some Blue Beacons do have their hands on it, like out in California. This is my fuel tank now on a Freightliner Cascadia. The reason it's shiny now is I just got it washed and I've polished this before, but we're going to brighten this up. Same with the steps, which actually you fellas missed a lot. Give it the Blue Beacon. So anyway, here's what aluminum looks like without ever polishing it. I've never polished my catwalk. See that dingy? It looks more like gray than it does anything else, right? Well, first thing you want to do, let your truck dry. But for the sake of time, we're going to dry it ourselves. Everything that we're going to polish, we're going to dry ourselves. It's better to do it when it's dry, though. So we're going to do the catwalk, chain hanger, both fuel tanks, and I'm going to try to do the steps if I feel like doing it, if I've got the energy. And this used to be polished, but this is roughly what it's going to look like. It's going to look like my handlebar here. So let me get started. I'll show you how to use it first, and we'll get to what it looks like afterwards. Alright, this here's gonna be a little tricky to do while holding a camera, so I got it leaning up against the bottle. Just bear with me here, fellas. What I'll show you. Take your cloth, alright? Take your deoxidizer. Anything that's aluminum, this will obviously, according to the name, deoxidize. Now, like I said, I've used this in the past. I've had people tell me it's impossible to polish aluminum. They said they've used CLR, aluminum polish, Brazero. Well, we're going to try a professional brand. Granted, it could be a little bit cleaner, but hey, that's Blue Beacon for you. What you're going to do is take this and you're going to sprinkle this 3/4 of the aluminum. Okay? So we're going to just run it, you know. Oh, you know what? Give me a second. I forgot to take the cap off. When you get this, there's a red cap inside. You have to unscrew the cap, pull this cap out. Set that there. Alright, try this again. We're just gonna sprinkle that green stuff all over here. Now this stuff is a little pricey, so you don't wanna overdo it. Now you can see it's turning bright, bright green. It's deoxidizing. Take your rag, wipe it all over the entire chrome. Make sure you cover every square inch. Alright, just like that. And you can see it's starting to turn like a lightish gray color. That's normal. Alright, make sure you get it all. Take care of our California. And of course, these TA rags ain't worth a darn. sure we got everything, and it's better if you use a lint-free cloth. I found, to be honest, what works the greatest is towels. Like the kind, I'm not going to tell you where I got it from, but like the shower towels you get out of the truck stop. You get your hands on one of those babies and cut it up into four pieces, man, that thing works awesome. All right, so we've covered just about everything. I see a few little lines here. So, I'm just gonna do a little bit more. Like I said, this stuff's expensive though, so use your own judgment how much you wanna do it. Remember, if it doesn't work the first time, it's probably because you've never polished the aluminum before. You can always do it a second time. All right. Rub that in like so. Everything looks nice and gray and clean. How about that? Now let me get the purple polish set up and ready, and I'll show you how we do that. That's it. Put the deoxidizer on there. The swirls that you see, that's okay. That's fine. Because either way, we've covered the entire thing in deoxidizer. So if you see these and you think you missed spots, don't worry. As long as you deoxidize the entire aluminum and cover every square inch, you're fine. When you get California purple, when you leave it sit for a long time, you'll get this, the separation. You need to shake this in vigorously for at least a good minute to get it fully mixed up. So I've covered the entire thing in purple polish. Now what you're going to do is rub your heart out. Rub until you ain't got no energy left. And just keep rubbing. I'm going to show you something. I'm going to show you when you think you're done. You'll notice it starts to turn black. That's normal. Make sure every square inch does turn black. You want it to be as dark as you can get it. Look at that darkness. We're gonna rub this entire thing down and I'll show you what to do next. Alright, you can see that it's turned mostly black. That's good. That's what we want. I'd have kept you on here while I did it, but man, I'll tell you what, it requires energy. Some people tell you you should use power tools, a power buffer. Sad truth, fellas. You want a job done right, don't do it with tools. Use your own strength. Buffers burn paint. They leave swirl marks. Do it with your hands. That's what Doug give them to you for. All right, now hold on 1 second. Take your super soft Cowboys buffing towel, whatever the heck you want to call it, and buff. Buff, buff, buff. Buff the black out. See that black? Just buff it out. Keep buffing. Keep using different rags to buff it. And just keep buffing until you don't get any more black on your rag. We're going to do that and get back to you. Gentlemen, I want to show you a shine. Reflective, not so much. Reflective, shiny, not shiny. Take a good close look at that, fellas. God, that's beautiful, isn't it? And the camera on this phone sucks, but take a look at that shine. And take a look at that dull looking. What the heck is that? They call that metal. Oh, no. Well, that's your shine, fellas. Do the rest of the truck the same way. Remember, oxidizer. Rub it all in. Cover the entire aluminum. Wipe it all until it's dry. Take your purple polish. Cover all the aluminum. You can squeeze it on a towel, or you can squeeze it directly on the aluminum. Your choice. Wipe that aluminum and scrub and scrub and scrub until it turns completely black.
it'll turn really dark. If you think that's a problem, it's not. It's normal. It says so on the bottle. When you're done with that, you're going to take your buffing towel and you're going to buff like you have never buffed before. You're going to use every last bit of energy polishing your truck, but boy, it is worth it. I'll include pictures of the fuel tanks for when I'm done, the chain hanger, and if I feel like it, I'll do the steps. I haven't debated because I use them so much. It's like it's really not even worth polishing. They get dirty too quick. I'll show you pictures when I'm finished. Best of luck to you fellas. Everybody, hours later the next day, and after a little bit of rain, still with that wash, that's the wheels plate. Can't do the back wheels because them wheel covers that was on there, wheels are all scratched up. Fuel tank reflective shine. That walk, fuel time. After hours and hours and going through dust, she still has a good shine. The power of California Custom. So y'all make the choice yourself. Decide what's best for you, but personally, I think that's worth it.